things like the Z-Mac came out, the rest of Jack's was the 42s. They came up with a little more advanced. Yeah. They got more and more advanced. Out of all the stabilization technologies that are out now, the Z-Mac is probably one of the most simplest ones. They're very limited, they're very straightforward. But there's a few key features that we want to make sure that we hit every time when using the Z-Max. We're going to talk about the components of the Z-Max, and then we're going to pull it all together, actually put the Z-Max together. We'll show you a few things, even lifting capabilities with the Z-Max. Get kind of creative with it, right? The simple anatomy and the simple ratchet strap, right? The biggest mistake that we make when we put the Z-Max in service in an extrication is not taking all the slack out of the ratchet. If you don't take all the slack out of the ratchet and you leave it on this side, you wind up binding up the ratchet. You might as well take it and chuck it off to the side and fix it when you get back to the firehouse. Because once we do that on scene, there's just no way to fix it. You have to sit there and actually mess with it to get it all unwrapped. So make sure that you take all the slack out of this ratchet. On the Z-Mag itself, the hook, there should be a D-ring, a hook. The D-ring allows you to wrap the post and come back to itself. Right, once you wrap it, make sure you take all the slack out of it. Make sure you take all the slack out of it, all right, and secure it to the post. The other option is, if you have enough, to bring it back down to the base on itself, like so, right? So if you can go around an object, maybe a post, cars on its roof, we can wrap the post, bring it back down to the base, take the slack out of the ratchet, right? The other thing is, you guys want to give me a hand, the other option is, put that one to that other side away. The other is, you can oppose the Z-Max. The other one is, you're opposing the Z-Max. Right? Once you oppose them, take the slack out of this. Take the slack out. Now make sure that your strap is nice and straight. Okay? Or as straight as possible. We take the slack out, and now we've essentially opposed our Z-Max. Right? This can actually works actually very well with the car on its side. If you wind it up going once to the undercarriage and one to the trunk, right? You're gonna need a purchase point on the side of the trunk or the hood of the car. You can make that with your air chisel or a quick little bump of your housing tool. We'll give you a nice purchase point to fit the tips in. Right?
Just the tip?
Just the tip. If you do this configuration, what I want you guys to be aware of, if you ratchet, when it comes time to ratchet, if you ratchet too tightly, you will create lift. These bases will push up against each other, and you'll actually create lift. Now, these are not designed to lift, but be careful what you're doing. Z-Mags are meant, and Z-Mags Rescue 42, Rescue Jacks, whatever it is that you're using, are all designed to work together with Crivy. Right? This isn't meant to be just to be put in the service alone. So your wedges, your 4x, box crib, whatever the case might be, put them in and then put your Z-Mags in place. When you're putting the Z-Mags in service, when you go to stabilize the vehicle, right, we determine we're on the undercarriage. Talk to different people tell you different things. You can use two Z-Mags on the undercarriage. You can oppose them and put one on the undercarriage, put one on the top side of the hood, to flip around the opposite way. To me, whatever works. I don't get heartburn specifically about where you put it. So long as it's put into operation correctly. Alright? So when we put it in service, we find the undercarriage of the vehicle. We can do it here. Right? Take the Z-Mag and drop it in. Everything that you do with the Z-Mag can be done just as you're seeing me do it. Once it's in, the entire tool can be manipulated with your leg. Don't get all crazy trying to get down on your knees and try to handle it. Put the tip on it, slide it in.
Yeah.
with all our slack out. We took our slack out. Ratcheted. The angle, see the angles how narrow they are? It's a very steep angle. What's going to happen is that base is going to pick right up. Right, so you want to bring that strap as low to the ground as possible and as straight in front of the base as possible. Right? So that you can effectively create that triangle effect for stabilization. Right? Again, this all works together in conjunction with privy. You got to put some wedges or some 4x or 2x to make sure that vehicle stays on. The other thing is, when you're putting this into operation, understand you're going to be working with a vehicle that's on its side. Right? 9 out of 10 times. Make sure you are on one knee. You want to reach for that anchor, you're on one knee. So if I need to bail out, I can bail out of the way and get out. Right? Don't get complacent and get on your knees. In a situation where you're working in a hot zone, you're working in a collapse zone, and you're not going to be able to get out. Right? Stay away from exhausts. Remember, these vehicles have been running for a while. They're going to be on the side. Everything's going to be hot. Everything on the undercarriage of the vehicle is considered hot. So be careful. Watch your fuel lines. Stay away from suspensions. Right? When you see that vehicle on the side, it's very easy to get caught up and go, I'm going to hook it right to the axle. You hook it right up to the springs. Stay away from suspensions and try to avoid them as much as possible. These particular set of Z-Mags come with a nice option if we needed it, which is the extensions. You add an extension, drop another 4x, now this becomes a two-person operation. Right? Pretty straightforward, guys. The biggest thing I can tell you is, the biggest teaching points for the Z-Mag, take all the slack out of your strap before you start ratcheting. Watch your angles. You don't want to go too steep. Anything below 45, back. Alright, stay between 45 and obviously 90. You don't want to go 90. Anywhere in that area, complete the triangle. Find a low anchor point as possible. Take all the slack out and ratchet. If you're off to the side, once you set it, if you're off to the side, I'll tell you right now, it's going to come off. But if you set it correctly, the way to check it is, once this is in, bring your foot over, tap it from underneath. If you stick your foot up in here, push up on it hard, it's correctly, it's not going to move. It's not going to move. So, very simple. It's quite possibly the most straightforward of the stabilization components of any of the stabilization systems that are out there right now. The other ones, like the rescue jacks, can lift. Once you put them in service, you can lift with them. You can form a tripod. This is very straightforward. Vehicle on its side. One person, maybe two. Operation. Done. No. You can put the extension and put 2 8-footers and 2 12-footers. It doesn't matter. So long as your anchors are correct. Now, if we decided we needed to, put 2 12-footers in service, understand that you're limited to the length of your strap. The other thing you can do is, depending on the situation, if you wanted to oppose your Z-Mags, and you were a great distance away, you can take these and hook them together. Right? Now you can take your slack out and ratchet. If for whatever reason you're too far away and your strap doesn't reach the base over here, you can always do this. The only problem with this is, see the ratchet on this side? There are the ratchets on different sides of each other. So you may get a little tweak depending on how much you torque. Hasn't been a big issue. Again, whenever you oppose Z-Mags, you start to pull those bases in. As those bases get pushed in, these get pushed up. Them in conjunction with your lift bags, right? Make sure you recheck your privy. Everything you do when you lift, the car's on its side, when you have a patient trapped underneath, we start creating vertical lift with lift legs, and we stabilize the vehicle beforehand, assign somebody to make sure we recheck the Z-Max and we recheck our grip, because the Z-Max will come out. No matter what system you're using, they will come out as we create that inch or two to slide that thing around. So be cognizant of that. Turn around, check your grip. Anytime you take a piece of metal, you take a fork, you feel the roof, remove something off that vehicle, come back and check your Z-Max. If we remove that load off the vehicle, it becomes lighter, right? Maybe we shifted it, maybe one of those bolts is holding it up, come back and recheck it, right? At night, what I like to do when we put them, finally just put them until we're done, is I'll pick up the slack, either tuck it up in here, get it out of the way, and if you have time, the driver, if you're the driver, or you just have a set of three hands, take it home without the phone right here. Because what happens? Vehicle on the side, this now becomes a trip hazard. Alright, 3 a.m., we're hustling, we're moving around, we're working hard. We don't see this, now this becomes a trip hazard. So if you're in a position where you're the driver engineer or the office, you have a set of hands, the officer moving right behind each of your Z-Max so the guys can see it. Alright? And all went pretty fast, there's a lot of information here. Guys, break them up, put them together, go into service, I don't care, whatever.